Greetings all on this wonderful day, praising King Selassie, speaking about immigration. This is the talk of the town, and so I'm going to examine what this means. Why are we hearing about this? Immigration is nothing new. If you have a business and you have a product, you can sell that product for more if people want it. The business is the United States. The product is the dollar. And as Frederick Douglass states, power concedes nothing without demand. Those that print and control the money supply seek to increase its demand. This is the reason why agencies have popped up to secure the value and to eliminate any threats. Think about all the activity around. What is the basis of it? Why are people moving around? What are people doing? Most of the time, they're chasing this. However, recently, people have come to the realization that spending your life seeking this is a form of slavery. That this makes a lot of promises and yet fails to deliver. As you see, the products not lasting, and yet people working harder, longer hours for less wages, and not enjoying the work that they do. So there is a surplus of labor. The central banks and the IMF work to extract maximum productivity through labor around the world. You can take one note from one country and bring it to another country and get more out of it, a bigger bang for your buck. This is all in the inner orchestration of the Monetary Fund International. And so, today, these benefactors find a need to market this product. You see the sitcoms, the people living in nice houses, and you're thinking, wait, is this how most people live? You know, they don't show somebody hanging out of a gutter in some projects, scrapping for crumb in the corner somewhere. No, it's people living comfortably. This is part of the promotional process. Build the perception in people's minds that if they just get to a location and contribute, I paying taxes. They will too reap those benefits to realize the American dream. Most everyone that lives here, has lived here for some time, know that this is pure fantasy. Only those willing to suck on the nipple, man, beast, achieve these opportunities. And so there is an effort underway to replace those that scrutinize the current structure. And there is a surplus of labor. And the notion is this is the place to be, the land of the free where everybody wants to come. You hear the supremacists saying, if people are so oppressed, then why do they keep coming here? If you recall, the African slave trade produced an enormous amount of wealth for very few amount of individuals that were losing their economic standard of feudalism because they had people that had also come to the realization of their existence. And there was threats of uprising, and coupled with the scarcity of the natural resources. So there was a need for an expansion. And civilizations were disrupted. Populations were forced by violence to a strange land. This America now, called the United States, extracted those benefits, existed to drive people through slavery. And those benefactors of this period that continues today through the mass incarcerations did not just dissolve into thin air. They passed their wealth down through generations. And in the process, they corrupted nations by installing bourgeois governments function in their interests by again extracting human resources as well as natural. And therefore, because the protections of the populations were eroded, those populations come to a place where they must fight or flee or die. And many have sought relief through relocation. And therefore, the reason why the immigration. So, the message that the ruling rulers are sending the world is you're lucky to be here. And we have many people willing to take your place, effectively boosting demand for their baby, Caesar. Selassie.